the song, the conga to Mississippi.
Mm-hmm.
I want everybody to be free.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe people in the Congo are free?
No.
Why not?
Yeah, going back to the same story.
What is free? What is freedom to you, Merman?
Freedom to me is the fact that I'm free to love, to be with some people, to say what I want to say.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's me, freedom. If I can speak my mind, if I can live without envy of another person, mm-hmm. if I have at least something for my family, if I can die today and leave something for my family yeah. behind.
Yeah, that's freedom, you know, to you.
That's freedom yeah. for me. Though I know I'm dying, at least it's my time to go, so the new generation is gonna take over. Mm-hmm. At least I leave them with something. Yeah. That's never happened in the Congo.
Well, that's what I love about America, that we are free here, and we are free to speak, and we are free to earn, to leave
exactly.
things behind.
Compared to where
yes,
we come
definitely.
From, you guys are way yeah. free.
Yes, we are definitely free. Yeah. And do you believe, because the song is from Congo to Mississippi, do you believe the people in Mississippi are free?
I want the people to be free. The freedom that I'm talking about is the freedom, spiritual free, freedom, you know? Because I'm talking about slavery, back in the time.
Right.
Yeah. So the African people came from Africa.
Yes,
to
indeed.
Crossing the Atlantic mm-hmm. to America, to Central America, all over the world. I mean, all over the West Hemisphere. Yeah, so my talking about that freedom is that the fact that we need to understand the African who are in America and the African who are back in Africa to be united.
Oh.
Yeah. To be united, to realize that we are this nation that is the most powerful.
What brings you to America?
Music brought me here. Playing for Change brought me to...
Talk about Playing for Change, please.
Yeah, can you allow me to describe Playing for Change?
I want you to.
Playing for Change was an idea of a guy, Mark Johnson,
mm-hmm.
a studio engineer.
Right.
He decided on the way to the studio, he saw some great musician on the street. Then he went
Tell
to
me where he was first.
In New Jersey.
New Jersey,
yeah,
okay.
On his way to, he used to work in Hit Factory in New York City.
The Hit Factory.
Yeah.
Yes, I think we all know the Hit Factory in New York City, yeah.
On his way to the studio, he saw some guys singing crazy in the subway.
Yeah.
And the people stood there. The train came passing by. Nobody went to the train. So he realized, wow, the greatest music is not just the only one, the one that I always have in the studio. Good music can be everywhere.
Yes.
So he decided to bring the studio to the people. That was the first step. So after
by bringing the studio to the people, what do you mean by that?
Like have a mobile studio, start recording musician in the street, bring the studio.
Oh, so he literally took the studio
yeah.
out of the studio, made it mobile,
yeah.
and took it to people on the streets.
Yeah.
Get out. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then he started recording musicians, audiovisual, all over the world. Like there was a song, Stand By Me, that
yes.
he did first.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then he recorded it, I think, in 50 kind of countries
mm-hmm.
around the world. And then he made a video of that 5 minute or 6 minute of that everybody inside.
Yes.
So the people loved it. Everybody got involved.
So it was everyone from different
country,
parts of the world,
yeah.
singing Stand,
singing
By,
Stand
Me,
By Me,
but they were unsigned artists who were just street artists.
Yeah. We are part of it because he did One Love on the, that One Love was a different, the second song that he did. I was in One Love that time.
Uh-huh.
So that was the first step. Then they put it in wherever it went, they loved it, and then it became like a revelation of the
right.
thing, yeah. And then he decided, now what should I do now that the inspiration is this big?
Mm-hmm.
What should I do? He decided maybe we should build a foundation to use whatever we did here that really came back to us. How do we give it back? So they build the music, they build the foundation, building music schools around the world and teaching kids for free.
Oh.
Right now we got like 15 programs all over the world, in Africa, in Brazil, in Nepal and Tibet.
So the Playing for Change is now created a school for different people across the world.
Yeah.
Children across the world to learn how to play.
So we go to a place, help them do the thing. Mm-hmm. They build the music, they just finance them. They do the build everything by themselves, and they run it by themselves. So Playing for Change is just that, like the umbrella on top of it.
Wow.
So yeah, in Ghana, Senegal, South Africa.
So how did you get involved with Playing for Change, though? So you were in the Democratic Republic of Congo.
I am from there, but I was living in South Africa.
You were living in South Africa.
Down, yeah.
And
in 2006.
In 2006.
Yeah, Mark Johnson and the crew on their way to record Stand By Me and One Love, they came to South Africa to record musicians. And they found me and the band playing in a restaurant.
So you were one of the groups that Playing for Change found in the restaurant playing?
Yeah, I was one of the artists.
Ah, wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And so now you're a part of this revolution.
Yeah, I was just getting there. After creating the schools, then they came up with the Playing for Change band.
Yeah.
With the musicians that they recorded. We are like 500 musicians or 1,000 musicians. So they selected, bam, 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 and then the 10 piece from like 9 countries on one stage.
Wow.
So, and then we represent our countries and Playing for Change all over the world.
Well, thank you for bringing your worldwide music right here to the Tammi Mack Late Show stage. Everybody, give it up for Mermans. This is not the first show that I've had talking about the African diaspora.
Yeah.
And every time we have the conversation, there are Africans who sit on this stage and talk to me about becoming one. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting how the rumors surface and how the urban legend begins that our African sisters and brothers, aren't really that fond of Americans who are black. And for me to sit here and oftentimes hear Africans say, no, we're one.
Yes.
We're all, it just lets me know that that is not true, which is exactly what you said.
I think here is the perspective that I look at it from. The minute you start to learn about your culture, the minute you start to learn about your history, the minute you start to learn about how the divide came, you'll begin to trace your steps back and unlearn the things media has indoctrinated in you over time. The system has created the perception that you have abide with for years. The minute you begin to unlearn these things, you don't see yourself as an African American. You don't see an African like, oh, you're an African, we're different. You see your people as one. And when you look at it from that perspective, when you see a black man, you call him an African, right? Now, we also have the people who I would say have some level of ignorance. I don't mean it in a repulsive way, but I actually mean it in the sense that they don't know. Let's use the word, they don't know.
Yeah.
Right? So such people will create a divide when they have a conversation. Oh, you African. You African-American. Right?
Right.
But the moment you unlearn these terms and begin to realize that my ancestral home is Alkabalan.
Ooh.
The ancient name of Africa before the Europeans named it Africa.
Yes.
As soon as you begin to realize these things, you begin to look at your people closely and realize that what they are reflecting right now is the perception that has been projected on them by a system designed to divide and conquer a great people.
There it is. Let's talk about your music now. Right. Is that okay?
Why not?
So you said that you didn't even discover your musical talent until you stepped foot in America.
No, not really. No.
So how so?
Like, I haven't said that. So.
Okay. Well. What? Okay. Well, maybe I misunderstood.
I've been doing music all the way from Nigeria.
Right. But it wasn't until you got to Los Angeles. Until what?
What happened was I got recognized here.
Ah, okay. So,
which
it wasn't
means
until you
the music
moved to
traveled from Lagos, Nigeria, across Africa to America.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's the origin, Lagos, Nigeria.
Got it.
So now it moved here, and I'm surprised. And there are platforms streaming me, platforms supporting me, and I've been nominated, right? Shout out to Just Jojo Entertainment. I was on that platform, and that was the vehicle that moved the music across the platforms that mm-hmm. was able to recognize me.
Right.
So in recognizing my talent, I said, look, there's a great opportunity right here, you know? And I came back again. And I came back again. I got in touch with some people, some amazing people over time. We've been having great relationships. Sokari, mm-hmm. my producer, and Stonebelt is a very good friend of mine. And plus, I've been talking in connections with Amplify Africa. And I realized there's a lot of great people here. And
yeah.
I just wanted to break free and do something new. But however, I've been doing music back home for about 10 years. I have like 2 mixtapes out. And Tarela is a name that is known. And I'm still building on it to expand it. And being here is amazing. And it's a blessing to be on the show as the first interview for the year.
Well, yes, it's a blessing to have you on the show.
Thank you.
Where can we find your music? How can we find you?
Yes. Let's do this. Before now, I was Squeeze Tarela. So I took.
Why they call you the record killer?
A record killer is one
that kills the record.
Yeah, just get in there, kill it. You know what I mean? From the beginning, okay. I just wanted to identify myself like when you get the opportunity to be in the studio to make a song,
kill it.
Just kill it.
No, let everybody, because I want you to kill my stage one more time before
more
we
time.
Go.
I'm a blessing.
But please let us know where we can get your music. Instagram, your social media, what,
my
Spotify?
My social media, you can follow me on Instagram at iSqueezTarela, at iSqueezTarela. You can get it there. You can also follow me on my YouTube channel, Tarela Music. I got a video out there, Bigger Life.
The video's hot, by the way.
Thank you so much. And you can also check me out on Spotify as Squeeze Tarela. Now, I used to be Squeeze Tarela. I decided to redefine myself so people can identify with my roots. Tarela is from the south of Nigeria, mm-hmm. precisely Delta State area, Warri. And I'm a proud Nigerian, proudly African. So I wanted to connect people with my roots and where I come from. So I transformed from being Squeeze Tarela to Tarela. So right now, everywhere I go, when people say, what's Tarela? What's the meaning? I say, it means peace and love. But you know what? It's an ethnic name from the Ijaw Nation, from the south of Nigeria. So that's it.
Well, thank you. Bring the south side of Nigeria
yes.
right there to the middle of the Tammi Magley
yes,
Show stage. Give it up for Tarela.
Thank you so much.